there, it's time to reflect the quarter one earnings and business update for Volition Rx. I can't believe time has passed so quickly. Cameron Reynolds, CEO, than when we were talking about the full year results for 2020. But bring us right up to date, and my guess is there's been a lot going on.
Yes, Nick, it's yet again been an incredibly busy time for us, particularly during the pandemic. We've managed to get a huge amount achieved. And I think in many, many key areas, people, we've greatly expanded the commercialization team. We're full tilt now to get our products out there. We think we've got a fantastic platform, and now is the time to commercialize. Patents, Jake's been in the basement, if you will, writing a huge amount of new intellectual property on our very exciting NETosis area, mostly. And also, we've been granted a lot of patents from before, so that's been fantastic. Publications, and now that we're really confident of our platform, we're publishing in much, much more than we were before in very good journals, and the all-important products. So, yeah, it's been incredibly busy in all four key areas of our platform, which I'll go through a bit later.
Thanks very much, Cameron. Stay right where you are, because we're going to come back to you for more detail around those business updates, because I'd now like to hear about the all-important numbers from the CFO for Volition, Terry Hughes. Terry, you've only been around with Volition since February, but as we've heard, it's been a busy time. So update us on the quarterly financial results.
That's right, Nick. It's been a very busy first quarter. And for me, I joined in February and we went straight into a fundraise. And that's really set the tone for the quarter. This quarter has been all about the cash. We raised a little over $20 million through a public offering and also through our At The Market program. That put us in a very strong financial position. We ended the quarter with $33 million of cash in the bank, and that leaves us in a good position to deliver on our milestones.
Well, that's good news that you've been raising capital, but I gather you've also got some news about the fact that you've been raising revenue this quarter.
That's right, Nick. We recorded $25,000 of revenue from our Nu.Q Vet beta launch in the US. Our commercial team has also been very busy building a pipeline. We've seen lots of interest on the vet side in the US, particularly with respect to licensing and distribution. We've also seen interest in Europe from our Nu.Q Discover product, which we also expect to deliver a solid revenue through the balance of the year.
So as ever, a lot of activity, Terry, quite a few incomings there, but what about outgoings? In other words, just update me on the expenses over the quarter.
So as you might expect, our expenses ticked up a little bit from $5.9 million in the first quarter of last year to $6.1 million in the first quarter of this year. That's mainly in sales and marketing and on the commercial side of things. And I would expect our monthly cash burn to be around $2 million a month.
So let's bring all that financial information into a conclusion. And also importantly, Terry, for you, finally, a quick look ahead to 2021.
So we finished Q1 of 2021 with $33 million of cash in the bank. That's our strongest cash position ever. And that puts us in a fantastic position to be able to deliver on the milestones, both R&D and commercial. So there's a lot going on, and I'll hand over to Cameron to tell you more.
Well, thanks very much, Terry. And Cameron, back to you now. You've been strengthening your IP, your intellectual property. We're going to hear more about those four pillars in a moment. But I also gather that you've been quite heavily involved in publications.
Yes. Now the platform's stable and we're very, very happy with our intellectual property. We're really cranking up the publications. To be taken seriously in this space, show how fantastic our platform is. Apart from products, which we're very active in, we're really going to start aggressively publishing now. So we attended two great conferences in this last quarter, even despite the pandemic. We've also been published twice, including some very good journals, and we have a couple which are imminent as well.
So plenty to read about in Volition publications. Let's look at those four pillars that you are developing within the business. The first of those is Nu.Q Vet. And just update us on how the beta launch is going.
Yeah, the launch has been absolutely fantastic. So we launched late last year. And the aim of this, just for a recap, was to sort of street test all the components of our test, not the test itself. That's been working great. exactly as we expected. Platform is extremely stable. But all the key things for a national launch, this is the beta launch, pricing, shipping, and you know, all the things, the feedback, all that. So that's gone very, very well. We're close to being able to launch nationally now. It's also really attracted the interest of the big players in the vet space. And so it's been very, very active in the last couple of months in the licensing and distribution space in the vets. So we'll see a lot more on that in the coming quarters. And also, we're really, really happy to have had Tom come on board. He was a top executive at Mars, which is the world's biggest pet company, director of business development. And for him to come on board from that size of company to our just launching Nu.Q Vet shows his confidence in what our platform can be and what we can be in the vet space. And I think it's going to be greatly help to us to have someone of his tremendous experience of building businesses in the vet space, and he's a vet.
Well, the next pillar, Nu.Q Capture, it's very much one of your breakthrough technologies. What's the latest news there?
So yeah, that was one of the key publications in Nature Scientific Reports. So again, a great publication. This was one aspect of Nu.Q Capture, which centers around the mass spectrometry. So I won't get into the details. It's quite technical, but very exciting, a really good paper for us. And we expect it to be a really good breakthrough enabling technology in the liquid biopsy space, and we're hopeful of launching our first product in this space next year in 2022.
Okay, well, NETosis is our next subject, the third pillar. I had the privilege of discussing that with the very knowledgeable Dr. Jake McKellough, your Chief Scientific Officer. How are things progressing on that front?
I think it's actually, to be fair, it's taken us by surprise how well it's worked in a very wide range of areas to do with NETosis. So again, what's NETosis? Why are we doing it? NETosis is a very key part of your immune system, which is great. But like any good thing, if you have too much of it, it can be very harmful. And it's thought to be the major cause of death through COVID, through sepsis, and a range of other conditions. So extremely good if it's in the right amount, extremely bad if it's in excess. And our assays are proven to be extremely good at measuring the NETs for a whole wide range of potential uses, from monitoring the progression of the disease, hopefully prognostic. But also, we've been working with a few companies who have now treatment for NETosis, trying to remove the excess NETs from your system. And we released the first data just before the last earnings call in an animal model that had worked incredibly well. Our assay did, and so did their technology. And we haven't made exactly who they are public yet, but we're talking to a wide range of groups and collaborating with a wide range of groups with our assays being used in their trials and in background work. So we're in the process now of getting a lot more data, which is a lot of it's been run and it's in the process of being published. So you'll see a lot of that coming up. And we're also in the process of trying to work out the best way of launching these as a product. But we're very excited, huge amount of new intellectual property. And I think it's going to be a very, very big part of our success going forward.
Well, let's finish on the fourth pillar with switching to human cancers. And obviously, COVID's had a massive impact on diagnosis and treatment around the world. Has it also impacted on the development of Nu.Q from your perspective?
Yes, not the platform itself, which is obviously we have and is very robust, but it's certainly affected the collection of the trials. You know, we've discussed many times on earnings call, EDRN, which is a government research group in the United States, has paused collection. So that's just nothing we can do about it. Also, the trials we're running in the blood cancers may well be delayed as well. We're working through that now. We'll have information on that in the near term as well. But luckily, the trials in Asia have been running full steam ahead. They are collecting in Taiwan. And we've got some negotiations going in a few different things in Asia. So I think if there's any movement in this space in the large marquee trials this year in colorectal lung, it will be from Asia.
Okay, so something to look forward to there. And another thing we can look forward to is a new development within Volition. Can you tell me more about Nu.Q Discover?
Yes, Nick. We launched a service lab in Silver One. What's a service lab? Just means we use our products. Instead of selling the products, we run them as a service. We've had a lot of interest, and we have a bunch of quotes out now with some of them are reasonably large pharma companies, biotech companies in cancer and NETosis, using a range of our assays to answer a lot of clinical questions, usually on monitoring. So there's revenue now, we expect to have some in the short term, But then also, if it becomes a key part of their drug or therapy, whatever it is, then you go back for a commercial license, which is a lot more lucrative.
So Silver One, which is close to your current facility in the Namur area of Belgium, is not only up and running, but it's an integral part of the business now.
Yeah, Dick, it really, really is. So we're manufacturing our own plates there, the most basic format. Also, we're starting to, on a large scale, manufacture our antibodies on the beads there, which is fantastic. Also, we've got a selection of recombinant nucleosomes, which we use for our own assays, which we're also offering as a service. So manufacturing as a service and as to sell. And also, it's just really helping us bring the cost of production down.
So, as we predicted, loads going on in Volition. Let's do the impossible task, Cameron. Let's distill that all down to a couple of sentences and also take a look ahead for milestones in 2021.
Well, we now really have a laser focus on making sure we can launch products and get revenue, because we have a great platform. Now we need to get out there and do it. So that's key to get more people. We did not have a big commercial team, not having any products. That makes sense. And now that's really being strengthened. We'll continue to do so. We'll continue to strengthen the publication and the patents and to get to all the products. So it should be a really good end to 2021. And I think we'll really couldn't be in a better financial situation, a better team, or really a better platform. So now it's all up for us to actually make it happen.
Well, thanks very much, Cameron Reynolds, CEO of Volition Rx, and also Terig Hughes, your CFO. I always love doing these interviews with you, because even at a time of problems around the globe, it makes me feel good hearing about all the positive things that are happening through Volition. So thanks very much for your time, and I look forward to speaking to you in 3 months' time to see how things are progressing. Bye for now.
Thank you, Nick, and thank you, everyone, for your time.